Welcome to Freeology Revision. In today's video I am going to be reading out an example essay for AQA Psychology. Our essays could give you some ideas on how to structure your own, and some of the AO1 and evaluation points you could use. However, improvements could always be made. Always remember to use as many key terms as possible. Essays are unfortunately marked based on the overall impression the examiner gets from it. Therefore, being vague in some areas could cause you to drop a level in marks. Always remember to try and do at least 2 AO3 points for 8 and 16 markers, but if you can stretch yourself to doing 3 AO3 points for a 16 marker then you are on the right track. Don't panic if you forget your points in the exam. Some evaluation points you may always be able to fall back on are individual differences, reductionism, criticizing the original study for lacking mundane realism, having population bias if it only studied a small number of people from one country or gender, or even criticize the ethics of the study. Also, it may be helpful to do the longer mark questions first when you get into an exam, this way you can make sure you have enough time for them. Just don't get carried away and end up missing out on those 4 markers. The following essay I am about to read will be in the description. It is a good starting point, but it is not perfect. To help you revise, you may wish to copy and paste our essay from the description and improve it. Feel free to post your improved essay in the comments section. Some psychologists argue that there is always more information about an event in a person's memory than can be recalled at any one time. This means that eyewitness recall can be improved by using certain techniques and methods. Describe and evaluate at least one way of improving eyewitness recall. Refer to evidence in your answer. 16 marks. One method that the police use to improve eyewitness recall is the cognitive interview. This is based on the assumption that memories are all interconnected instead of being separated, individual memories of an entire situation. Therefore, the method aims to use contextual cues to cue the recall of more information which the participant may not be able to recall during a standard police interview. The cognitive interview has 4 stages. The first is mental reinstatement. The participant is asked to bring themselves back to the time where the crime took place. For example, they may be asked to recall what happened before, their emotions, the weather, sights, etc. They are encouraged to use all 5 senses in hope that something previously seen as inconsequential might cue the recall of something important. The next step is to report everything. The witness is asked to go through the event in chronological order, reporting everything even if it seems inconsequential in case this triggers the recall of something important. The interviewer does not interrupt in order to not interrupt the flow of the memory. The third step is to recall the event out of order, for example backwards. This is to disrupt any schemas, mental framework of how you expect a situation to play out based from previous experience, which may affect accurate recall. You may go to a restaurant, be seated, a waitress comes to take your order, but this may not have actually been what happened. The final stage is to recall the event from the perspective of another person, such as the victim. This further helps to disrupt any schemas. The success of the cognitive interview has been supported by research studies. One research study compared information gathered by the cognitive interview to the standard interview. It was found there was an 81% increase in the amount of correct information generated. This seems to suggest the cognitive interview is more successful. However, it may be that cognitive interview only increases the quantity of information recalled, not the quality. The same study also found an increase of 61% in incorrect information recalled. This suggests that the cognitive interview is only useful towards increasing the amount of information recalled, and that any information given by the witness should still be treated with caution just as any other interview style, as it does not guarantee accuracy. Further criticism comes from more research studies. One study throws into question whether or not all stages of the cognitive interview are useful. Different stages of the cognitive interview were compared with a control group using the standard interview. It was found that between stages, the accuracy of information recalled was largely similar across all and the control condition. It was only when a combination of report everything and mental reinstatement were used that the results began to show a significant increase in the amount and accuracy of research recalled. This suggests that not all stages of the cognitive interview are useful to police. Furthermore, many police may not even use the cognitive interview. This is because police time is very often stretched, and so police often use techniques to try and shorten interviews. Meanwhile, the cognitive interview takes a long amount of time and may not be useful due to the increase in false information given to. Also, it requires special training which is expensive and therefore most police stations do not provide this and cannot make use of the cognitive interview. This suggests that the interview may not be useful to police officers in the real world unless it is somehow shortened.